Hi, Monster Jam fans. Welcome out here to Raymond James Stadium for the next stop on Stadium Series Red. But before we can begin tonight's Monster Jam action, we'd like to honor all those who have served our country. Monster Jam and was built right here in the USA. And we're super thankful and grateful to have the opportunity to do these shows for all of you fans and to come to attend. If you serve the United States military, whether that be the Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, or Coast Guard, please rise and thank you for your service. God bless the United States of America. Tonight's national anthem is going to be presented by Avengers Racing and the Steel Titans Sports League. Please go check out these channels as they are really cool. Now please rise for our national anthem by Avengers Racing. Now presenting our national anthem, this is Avengers Racing in the Steel Titans Sports League.
By the dawn's
Coming out to the track next, your current season points leader, this is Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior.
Mm-hmm.
Coming after the track next. I'm saying 20 years of maximum destruction from Paxton, Illinois. This is Comments in Max D. Tampa, Florida. This is Monster Jam. Tampa, Florida, get loud because this is Monster Jam. All right, Monster Jam fans, it is now time for our first competition of the evening, Monster Jam Racing. Each driver will compete head-to-head in a one-on-one elimination tournament. For the winner of each race will advance on to the next round, culminating in the final round race on the road to Monster Jam World Finals 24 in Nashville, Tennessee. So, Tampa, Florida, get loud if you're ready for Monster Jam Racing. Coming out first, we've got Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior versus Camden Murphy in the Bakugan Dragonoid. Here we go, on your mark, get set, go. Ken Murphy with a crazy save right there at the end. And Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior will take advantage of this and get the win. Nice win for Bryce Kenny. Next up, we've got Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken versus Jamie Garner in El Toro Loco. Here we go, on your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be the Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Next up, we've got Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune versus Jeff Souza in Velociraptor, who is filling in for Travis Mowry. Here we go, on your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune. It is now time for the last race out here in round one. We've got Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl versus Matt Pagliarulo in Jester. Here we go, on your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. It is now time to kick off round two with Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior versus Tom Mintz and Max D. These are currently the top two in the season points. Who will win and move on to the semifinals? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior.
All right, there was actually a mistake on my part. In round one, won with that race against Nick Pagliarulo and Kraken and Jamie Garner in El Toro Loco.
Kraken messed up on the track where he went out too early. The track he was supposed to go like this in a full paperclip, but Kraken actually came out and did this.
They accidentally did the track wrong and will lose, and that means Jamie Garner will get an automatic advancement into round two, as he ended up winning that race. And it's time for round two now. Jamie Garner is now going to go up against Todd LeDuc in Megalodon. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. His rollover save from Jamie Garner. He does not go over the ramp, which means Todd LeDuc and Megalodon will get the win. It is time to continue round two here with Adam Anderson and Gravedigger versus Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune. Who will move on into the next round? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Caleb Blood with all kinds of mistakes, and your winner is going to be Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. And it's time for our next race out here in the semifinals. We've got Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl versus Mike Christensen in Vendetta. Who will go on the semifinals? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. It is now time to kick off the semifinals out here with Bryce Tanney in the Great Cliffs Mohawk Warrior versus Todd LeDuc in Megalodon. Who will move on into the final round? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Man, that is close. Todd LeDuc will crash. Matt and Reed look over the cliff to see who won that race. And looking over the footage, your winner is going to be Bryce Tanney in the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior. Who's going to go to the final round to face off against Bryce Tanney in the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior? Will it be Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl, or will it be Adam Anderson in Gravedigger? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Cole sending it over the finish line, and this is not a big air competition, and your winner is going to be Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. Competition. We start off today with 12 of the fastest Monster Jam drivers. We're now down the fastest two, Bryce Tanney, the Great Cliffs Mohawk Warrior, and Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. Who will win? Let's find out. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. And your winner is going to be Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. Nice job for Adam Anderson and Gravedigger on that racing win. He really needed it. He really wants to catch up and try to take the points lead. So really nice job to Adam Anderson and Gravedigger on this racing win. And see if Adam Anderson can carry that momentum into skills. As currently in the overall event standings, Adam Anderson and Gravedigger has got the lead. Bryce Tanney in second, and Cole Bernard in third. So those are your top three right now. Oh, we'll see here how it goes in the Great Clip Skills Challenge. Because that will be our second competition of the evening.
All right, Monster Jam fans, it is now time for our second
competition of the evening, the Great Blitz Skills Challenge. Each driver is going to get 2 attempts to pull off their best maneuvers on 2 wheels or a donut. 2-wheel maneuvers, you may see these drivers perform out here are anything from stoppies, moonwalks, poppers, sky wheelies, slap wheelies, bicycles, or maybe some huge vertical air. So, Raymond James Stadium, I need you to get loud if you're ready for the Great Blitz Skills Challenge. Coming out first, representing Team Spinmaster from Itasca, Illinois, this is Candy Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid. Nice air, Popper. And he's gonna set it down. 1 more attempt left to go. Nice, there's moonwalking it. Nice, so that's gonna moonwalk it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Camden Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid. For Camden Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid is going to be an 8.781. Your leader to kick things off here in the Great Blitz Skills Challenge will be Camden Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid. Next up, representing for Tomfoolery Motorsports, here comes Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Nice slap lay there from Nick Pagliarulo. 1 more attempt left to go. Nice bicycle, and that's going to be the end of the run for Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. It's going to be a 7.112 for Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Now it's going to begin them for second place. Your leader is still going to remain Camden Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid. Next up, here comes Jeff Souza in Velociraptor. Nice stoppie there for the first attempt for Velociraptor. 1 more attempt left to go. Nice little bicycle attempt, and that's going to be the end of the run for Jeff Souza in Velociraptor. For Jeff Souza in Velociraptor is going to be a 6.328. That's going to be good enough for third place. Your leader is going to remain Candy Murphy in the Bakugan Dragonoid. Next up, coming out of the shop in Deltona, Florida, this is Matt Pagliarulo in Jester. Nice there. Slap Willie on the first attempt. 1 more attempt left to go here for Jester. Nice tiny little bicycle, and that's going to be the end of the run for Matt Pagliarulo in Jester. For Matt Pagliarulo in Jester is going to be a 6.113. That is going to be good enough for fourth place. Your leader is still going to remain Camden Murphy in the Bakugan Dragonoid.
Next up, representing 20 years of maximum destruction from Axon, Illinois, this is Tom Menz in Max D. Nice there, maximum moonwalk right there. There, with not that much room here, so you got earlier in racing. He didn't have that much room, so very nice job there for Tom Menz. Nice there is gonna slap walk it right here. Nice there job. He's gonna set it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Tom Menz in Max D.
For Tom Menz in Max D, he's gonna be as 9.014. That's gonna be good enough for the lead. Your brand new leader is going to be Tom Menz in Max D. Next up from Fortville, Indiana, this is Jamie Garner in El Toro Loco.
Nice reverse wheelie. Nice there, Jamie Garner's gonna walk it across the pod. One more attempt left to go. Trying to find that car right there that's embedded. Nice there, he's got a popper. He's gonna set it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Jamie Garner in El Toro Loco.
For Jamie Garner in El Toro Loco is gonna be an 8.593. That's gonna be good enough for third place. Your leader is still gonna remain Tom Menz in Max D. Next up from Lafayette, Louisiana, this is Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune.
Nice there, Hopper. And she's gonna set it down. One more attempt left to go here for Soldier Fortune. Slamming it into the front of Dragonoid. And he's gonna set it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune.
For Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune is gonna be an 8.402. That's not gonna be enough for the lead. Your leader is still going to remain Tom Menz in Max D. Next up, representing for Team Throttle Monster, here comes Mike Christensen in Vendetta. Mm-hmm. nice donut. Remember, a driver can have an opportunity to do either two attempts on two wheels or a donut. And Mike Christensen is going to do a donut. Nice little donut right there from Mike Christensen in Vendetta.
Mike Christensen in Vendetta is going to be a 6.115. That is not going to be enough for the lead. Your leader is going to remain Tom Mentz in Max D. Next up, here comes Todd LeDuc in Megalodon.
Shark is looking for its prey out here. It's just lining up right here looking for a bicycle. Nice bicycle for the first attempt. One more attempt left to go here for Tom LeDuc in Megalodon. Nice, and he's got it into a moonwalk. And he's gonna set it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Todd LeDuc in Megalodon.
Todd LeDuc in Megalodon is gonna be an 8.819. That's not gonna be enough for the lead. Your leader, sir, remains Tom Benson, Max D. Next up, here comes Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl.
Nice reverse popper. And he's gonna walk it out. One more attempt left to go here for Cole Bernard. He's gonna get a little stoppy right there, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl.
For Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl is gonna be an 8.199. Not enough for the lead. Your leader is going to remain Tom Mentz in Max D. Next up, the current season leader representing the Mohawk Nation. This is Bryce Kenny in the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior.
Nice there, Soppy. Walking it up the pad, moonwalking it. Nice there, he's got it back into a wheelie. He's gonna set it down. One more attempt left to go here for Bryce Kenny. This is very a tight space. Nice, there's back on another wheelie. Wow. And he's gonna set it down, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk.
Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk, where it's gonna be a 9.020. That is gonna be good enough for the lead. Your brand new leader is gonna be Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior.
Next up, here comes the Black and Green Wrecking Machine, Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. That's just skywheeling it off the little cars right there and getting into a slap wheelie. Now he's comboing it into a wheel, into a stoppy. Nicer job. Nice there, he's got it into a little slap wheelie. One more attempt left to go here for Adam Anderson. Next, we're going to hold a bicycle into a sidewall, and that's going to be the end of the run for Adam Anderson and Grave Digger. Your score for Adam Anderson and Grave Digger is going to be a 9.115. That's going to be good enough. Your winner is going to be Adam Anderson and Grave Digger. Nice job for Adam Anderson for this win. He's gotten 2 for 2 so far this evening. Let's see if Adam Anderson can walk away with this overall event championship as Freestyle is up next. All right, Monster Jam fans. Here's the current overall event standings after our first two competitions here of the evening. Adam Anderson and Grave Digger still has the lead after winning both racing and skills. Second place is Bryce Kenny after finishing second in both competitions. And then third place is Todd LeDuc in Megalodon. Todd LeDuc is really close to catching up. He just really needs to have a really strong freestyle performance if he wants to try to get this overall event championship win. Meanwhile, we do have a couple trucks still struggling in the single digits. Those trucks are Vendetta, Jester, Velociraptor, Kraken, and Bakugan Dragonoid. Bakugan Dragonoid is so close to getting into the 10s. He just needs to win compete in freestyle, and he will make it there. Kraken really needs to get 4 more points, and so does Velociraptor. Jester needs 5 points, and Vendetta needs 2. Matt Pagliarulo suffering at the bottom. Sometimes the hometown curse is almost a hometown show for the Pagliarulos. So we'll have to see here. Hopefully Matt can break this hometown curse he's been having currently, and he can try to pull off a good freestyle and try to have a solid freestyle performance. That has been it with our halftime report. When we come back from halftime, it will be time for the BKT Tires freestyle competition. All right, Monster Jam fans, it is now time for the final competition in of tonight's Monster Jam event, the BKT Tires freestyle competition. Each driver is going to get 2 minutes to tear up the track to do their biggest and best moves. Stuff you may be able to see these drivers do out here are donuts, tentacle maneuvers, crazy saves, big air, or maybe even a backflip right there off the Morgan and Morgan backflip or off the 8-pack. Stuff the judges are looking for are creativity, wow factor, use of all obstacles, and the completion of the time. If you do not fill 30 seconds, you will not be able to qualify for a score. So, Raymond James Stadium, get loud if you're ready for the BKT Tires freestyle competition. Coming out first, he representing for Team Throttle Monster, this is Mike Christensen in Vendetta. 2 minutes starts now that I made his first hit. Clock is paused because there's something on the ground I do not want to step on during the run, so the clock has been paused for Vendetta. He will now resume. Nice there, Keith Sender from Vendetta.
Next donut.
Lining up for the backflip. Nice, he's gonna nail it. 30 seconds left to go here for Vendetta. Nice donut, and that's gonna be the end of the run for Mike Christensen. And Mike Christensen and Vendetta is gonna be a 7.513. That's gonna be good enough for the lead. Your leader kick things off in our BKT Tires Freestyle competition will be Mike Christensen and Vendetta. Next up, coming out of the shop in Deltona, Florida, this is Matt Pagliaruo in Jester.
Mmm.
30 seconds left. Lining it up here for the back flip. He's gonna nail it. The time is up. Nick Pagliarulo is gonna send it for you fans. And he's gonna save it. Wow, Nick Pagliarulo, what a save right there at the end as he sends it across Raymond James Stadium. Wow, what a nice end to the run for Nick Pagliarulo.
Incorrect.
8.998 for Nick Pagliarulo and Kraken. That's going to be good enough for the lead. Your brand new leader is going to be Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Next up, your 12-time Wolf Mouse champion from Paxton, Illinois, representing 20 years of maximum destruction. This is Thomas and Max D. Wow, look at that here from Menz. Truck is okay after that fall off the pool table. Wow, look at that save right there from Tom Menz. Nice, and another nice save. Menz was almost had probably staying freestyle of the year last week in Detroit with all the crazy saves he had. I'm gonna try to go back here again. Nice donut. Now he opens the Morgan backflip rim and he's gonna nail it. 30 seconds left. Hey, he's just gonna nail it right there. And that's gonna be the end of the run for Tom Menz in Max D. Tom Menz in Max D is gonna be an 8.701. That's gonna be good enough for second place. Your leader is still going to remain Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Next up, here comes Jeff Souza in Velociraptor. Mm-hmm. 30 seconds left for Velociraptor. Nice stop, Eli. Your jet suit is doing really good right now. And that's going to be the end of the run for Jeff Souza and Velociraptor. The score for Jeff Souza and Velociraptor is going to be an 8.522. Not enough for the lead. Your leader is going to remain Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Next up, representing Team Spin Master from Itasca, Illinois, this is Kimmy Murphy in the Bakugan Dragonoid. Nice air combo to kick the run off. This track is a really difficult track out here. With the parked trucks everywhere. This is a really difficult of a track right here. Camden Murphy and the Bakugan Dragonoid is going to be an 8.971. That's going to be good enough for second place. Your leader starting to remain Nick Pagliarulo in Kraken. Time to kick off the second half of freestyle here with Bryce Kenny and the Great Cliffs Mohawk Warrior. Standing. He really needs a good run right here. he's going to keep that second place and try to take the overall event championship win. Lining it up for the 8-pack right here. He's gonna nail it. Thanks, some of this is not right here on this Mohawk truck. And that's gonna be the end of time. 30 seconds left, I think, is what that actually meant. No, it's the end of time. Your score for Bryce Kenny and the Great Clips Mohawk Warriors is going to be 6.715. Not enough for the lead. Your leader is going to remain Nick Pagley, Rulo, and Kraken. Next up, representing the Crazy Bull from Fortville, Indiana, this is Jamie Gardner in El Toro Loco. Nice air, crazy and huge sends right here. Jamie is going big. Nice there, saving it from Jamie Gardner. Nice there, job. Jamie Gardner is sending it across the track. Nice there, donuts. Nice save right there. Wow, nice their job. 30 seconds left here for Jamie Gardner. Nice their job. He's gonna knock out one of the cars. Nice there, huge send across the track. Nick Pagley, Rulo must be getting nervous now, but Jamie Gardner is absolutely sending it. That's gonna be the end of time. One more last hit. And he's just gonna save it right there. Blowing that smoke out of the nostrils here at Tom Mentz's Max D. What an amazing run here for Jamie Gardner in El Toro Loco. Score for Jamie Gardner in El Toro Loco is going to be a 9.113. That's going to be good enough for the lead. Your brand new leader is going to be Jamie Gardner in El Toro Loco. Next up, representing the Black and Green Wrecking Machine from Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina, this is Adam Anderson in Grave Digger. Nice save right there from Adam Anderson. Mm-hmm. Nice, they're sticking it on the wheelie bar. Wow, nice, they're down there from Adam Anderson. Nice donut. Wow, nice or save. Another nice save right there from Adam Anderson. 30 seconds left. Lining up for the backflip. He's gonna nail it. Wow, he's just gonna go up there. Wow, nice serve job here from Adam Anderson. And that's gonna be the end of time. Adam's gonna burn it down for East Band. He's not gonna stop till the truck stops. Oh shoot. And that's going to be the end of the run for Adam Anderson and Grave Digger. Your score for Adam Anderson and Grave Digger is going to be at 9.009. Good enough for second place. Your leader is going to remain Jamie Garner and El Toro Loco. Coming up next, here comes Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. Cole is ready to go crazy out there. He's already losing the flag. Man, Cole's already going big. Wow, look at Cole go. Wow, he's already got a crazy save in there. Nice air, huge air there from Black Pearl. Nice donut. Wow, Cole is going big. Cole trying to take out his teammate out of the hot seat. 30 seconds left. Lining up for the backflip, and he's gonna walk the plank. Wow, nice job. Nice, there, it's the end of time. One more crazy hit for Cole Bernard as he's just gonna crash it right there into the ground. What an amazing end to the run for Cole Bernard and the Black Pearl.
For Cole Bernard and the Black Pearl is going to be a 9.225.
That's 9.255. That's going to be good enough for the lead. Your brand new leader is going to be Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. Next up, representing all the men and women in uniform from Lafayette, Louisiana, this is Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune. Caleb's having a really good run right now. Nice donut. Big air right there. Caleb's really throwing it down. Lying for the backflip. He's kind of saved it. Well, I didn't know what that was. Seconds left. Nice save right there. That's gonna be the end of time. And she's just gonna crash it right there. What a nice end to the run for Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune. Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune is gonna be an 8.311. Ooh! Not enough for the lead. Your leader is still gonna remain Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. Coming out last, here comes Tom LeDuc in Megalodon. Nice there, save from the dude. Nice save right there from LeDuc. You know, he's lining up for the back one in such a tight space, and he's gonna nail it. Wow, on LeDuc. Now he's gonna send it across the track. Saving it right there. Seconds left. Oh shoot! It's gonna fall off the ground, get a little paint chip right there on the top of the fin. You dare. Bogle Deuce, and that's going to be the end of the run as he's just going to send it across the track and roll it right there. One, that would be amazing into the run for Talbot Duke in Megalodon. It's going to be an 8.43 for Talbot Duke in Megalodon. That is not going to be enough for the lead, which means your BKZ Tires Freestyle winner is going to be Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. Nice job for Cole Bernard to get this freestyle win. This is 2 years in a row. Last year, Cole Bernard came here and he got the freestyle win. He came back again this year and got another freestyle win. Nice job there for Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl. 12 more points are going to go to his overall event standings. Very, very, very nice job for Cole Bernard. This is, I believe, is now his second freestyle win on the season. His first was in Anaheim, show one. So very nice job here for Cole Bernard in the Black Pearl for getting this win. Let's see if these 12 points can get Cole Bernard the overall event championship win. All right, everybody, your overall event winner has been decided, getting a total of 12 points in racing, 12 points in the Great Clip Skills Challenge, and 9 points in the BKZ Tires Freestyle Competition for a total of 34 points. Your overall event champion is going to be none other than Adam Anderson in Gravedigger. Nice job here for Adam Anderson to get this overall event championship win. This is Digger Country out here in Tampa. That's in, you know, Tampa, they really love Gravedigger out here. So nice job for Adam Anderson on this win. When this is going to help Adam Anderson catch up to Bryce Kenny and Tom Mentz to try to get that points lead. You know, very, very, very big GG and a huge W for Adam Anderson and Gravedigger. Now add up the season points and we're going to see what's happening in the season standings. GG to Adam Anderson. All right, everybody, that's been the end of today's events out here in Tampa. First off, here's the rest of today's results. Here's racing, overall, skills, and freestyle. Here are the current season points. Currently right now in the season points, Bryce Kenny still has the lead. Tom Mentz is only 5 points behind in second, and Adam Anderson is in third, only 10 points behind. This is super close right now. Camden Murphy is sitting in fourth place. Velociraptor's in fifth. Black Pearl in sixth. The tie between Megalodon and Kraken. It will be Megalodon, I believe. Megalodon in seventh. Kraken in eighth. No, wait. It'll be Soldier Fortune in seventh. Megalodon 8th, Kraken in 9th, Toroloco in 10th, Vendetta in 11th, and Jester in last place. Matt is just struggling right now. He wants to get to the 100s, he wants to pass and get out of last place, but he is struggling to do so. Hopefully tomorrow's show he can get out of last place, as he is 30 points behind. So Matt Pagliarulo really needs a good showing tomorrow. There's a tie between Tom Leduc is slowly starting to climb up this leaderboard. As if he can have a good event tomorrow, he can pass Caleb Blood. And if he has a super good event, he can maybe even pass Black Pearl. Jeff Seuss is holding down Velociraptor in the top five. The top three are just so close. It's going to be interesting to see what happens tomorrow. This tour's next stop will be tomorrow in Tampa, Florida. So please be sure to like and subscribe, and we'll see you all then. The points chase is really heating at the top right now with Adam, Tom, and Bryce. What will happen tomorrow? Will Bryce Kenny remain in the points lead? Or will Tom Mentz or Adam Anderson take the lead? We'll have to find out tomorrow, as we'll see you all then, everybody. Have a God bless night, and we'll see you all tomorrow for the next stop on Stadium Championship Series Red. Like and subscribe. Ring that notification bell. Share. Comment.
Mm-hmm.